Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Female gametophyte or ovule. We all know that during the process of reproduction, the male gametophyte and the female gametophyte. The male gametophyte will have pollen grains, where the female gametophyte will be having the egg cell. And without the female gametophyte, reproduction plans won't be possible. Today, we'll be studying the different parts of female gametophyte. The different parts of female gametophyte are nucleus, embryo sac, chalaza, integuments, micropolar end, egg apparatus, synergids, antipodal cells. Let us see the function of each and every part. The micropyle part. Now, the micropyle part is the part through which the pollen grain gains entry inside the egg cell. Now, this is the egg cell. And through micropyle, the pollen grains finds a pathway to gain entry. This is a process, or this is the pathway for fertilization. Funicles. Now, these are the parts that connect an ovule to the placenta of an embryo. Chalaza. These are nothing but upper basal part of an ovule. Nucellus. Now, nucellus basically differentiate or is formed to form the embryo sac. Once the fertilization takes place, next thing what has to form is the embryo sac for the protection of the egg, and nucellus forms that. Integuments. Integuments are nothing but they protect the nucellus as well as the embryo sac. Now, apart from this, there are things which are called as egg cell. This is called the egg cell. There are antipodal cells and synergid cells. Antipodal cells and synergid cells basically are accessory cells, and in some way they provide protection to the egg cell. Structure of ovule. Ovule basically consists of chalaza, the upper basal part of an ovule. It consists of funicles. This funicles attaches the body of ovule to the placenta of the ovary. Integuments. Integuments are layers present in the ovule which provide protection to the nucellus as well as to the embryo sac while the egg has been done after fertilization. Micropyle. Now, the micropylar end allows the entry of pollen tube, the tube that is formed during the process of double fertilization. Nucellus. Now, nucellus basically forms embryo sac that provides nourishment to the growing embryo after the process of fertilization. Egg apparatus. Egg apparatus basically consists of antipodal cells, synergid cells, and the egg cell, or you can say the female gametophyte. Egg cell is converted into zygote after fertilization in the egg apparatus. secondary nucleus. Now, secondary nucleus basically forms triploid primary endosperm, that is PEN, which forms the nutritive tissue for a growing egg cell, or you can say after the process of fertilization, it provides nutrition to the growing zygote. Antipodal cells are cells which are present in egg apparatus, and these cells degenerate or disintegrate after the process of fertilization. Antipodal cells are basically accessory cells along with synergid cells. So students, in this part of the chapter, we have studied the structure of ovule, or you can say the female part. I hope you all are clear with the concept of the structure of ovule. Thank you.